Good evening. Welcome to the night side of From Day One, as we continue with our fun little interactions with idiots with police. Tonight you find out when you realize you could have just gotten a ticket, but you're going to jail.
On February 24, 2023, an officer on patrol noticed a vehicle passing by without the female driver wearing her seatbelt in La Crosse, Wisconsin. Additionally, one of the taillight covers on the vehicle was broken. When the officer was turning around, she drove through an intersection without stopping and appeared to accelerate. As she disregarded yet another stop sign, she nearly got smoked by a crossing vehicle. She eventually stopped her vehicle in the middle of the road and bailed on foot into her house, locking the door. While waiting for backup, the officer recalled the residents from prior interactions. He soon recognized the 21-year-old female named Shaylin when she opened the front window to speak with him. He ordered her several times to come out, but she refused. Instead, she informed the officer that she was aware of her revoked driver's license, bond status, and did not want to go back to jail. But before we continue, let's hear a quick word from today's sponsor, Sonoran Desert Institute.
Yeah, that's not. Oh, and of course, and I just messed everything up. And we're not going to freaking cops. I think we're just at about where we need to be. Let's head back. Jeez.
To the door, I've told you that. No one wants to go to jail, but you have to, so. Following a records check, dispatch advised Shaylin was revoked due to a prior OWI.
Oh, was big surprise.
Four misdemeanor bonds and on probation. Sick bond, it would have been on your way. FYI, if you had just pulled over, it would have been a signature bond. You would have signed a piece of paper, and you would have been all. What? We would have issued you
Sigmon. Because it's OAR. It's traffic. Your bonds were criminal. It's a traffic violation. And you turn it into something more. You are now.
Why?
Because you ran from the traffic stop. If you went to Brand, you went to jail. You don't have a warrant. All you had was OAR. So if you were cooperative and decent, you would have got a Sigma and been on your way.
Well,
when you're not supposed to be driving, that's not harassing you. That's you're doing stuff you're not supposed to be doing. Plain and simple. But who's your probation agent? Well, I mean, if you need help, we'll help you. But you don't need help right now. You need to be an adult and take responsibility for an action that you did.
Yes.
It's either that, or when we contact your agent, it's going to be an uncooperative person. And if your agent is Barb, or who's your agent? She will hold you more than 1 weekend if you don't cooperate. I can probably promise you that. So either you go to jail now and you maybe not get a probation hold, and you maybe don't sit the whole weekend because the judge can let you out on a sig bond, or you go to jail later and you sit for a whole month.
I'm not gonna get out. I'm not an idiot.
What? Who's not gonna let you out? Judges?
I'm not gonna get out.
You do? No, that's it.
If you would have just went in, they wouldn't put a probation hold on you for anything.
Probation's not going to put a hold on you for a traffic offense, but for running from us, they will put a hold on you. Now you're going to have a probation warrant if you don't cooperate, and then you're going to get arrested anyways at some point when you don't want to go to jail, and then you'll But think about it, you're still going to sit all weekend, because when you do finally get arrested on this warrant that's going to be issued for tonight, you're going to end up going for more than 1 weekend. You'll sit for a lot longer. That's what we're trying to tell you. Just because you don't want to go this weekend, it's going to be 3 days max, or it's going to be a whole month. You can easily get a 30-day. That's what's going to end up probably happening. I mean, and then you're going to have to pay to have your car taken out of impound. I'm not trying to. Your car's not parked legally. It's not parked legally, and you just committed a
crime. Copy, are you still on the phone with them?
You just committed a crime with it, so it can be towed.
Okay, wait, you got me.
You're the one not cooperating. If you come out and cooperate, that's a whole different ballgame. We can work with you. You can make any phone call you want if you come stand out on the porch. We don't have to hook you up. We don't have to put you in cuffs right away.
If you cooperate, you can call whoever you want.
I'm not lying. As long as you're decent and cooperative, we're not going to hook you up right away. You can sit right here and talk to whoever you want to talk to. There's no reason for us to put you in cuffs right away unless you're not going to cooperate. You even get to move your car.
But if you're going to sit here and play games, we're going to do everything that we can do.
What?
I'm trying to call my dad.
Okay.
Yeah, she had to stop earlier, so it wasn't fleeing, it was just on the whole block.
Okay.
So technically, you would have fleeing if you lost the play that game.
Yeah.
Top right, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, no, top right. It's a whole different ballgame to work with her, but that's
Don's here, so she's got quick choices. Shayla, you can come out right now or it's getting towed.
Don't trust him. Come out right now or it's getting towed. That's your two options.
So what you got?
You're not in charge here, so it's getting towed or come out.
All right. It's your choice. I told you, if you come out and cooperate, you can move your car.
If you're not going to cooperate, you don't make the calls or the decisions, and it's going to get towed. They're here. Your dad's not going to be able to move it. We're not going to let him unless you come out.
Well, he's here. We're not going to hold him. So you need to come out. Come out and call your dad. Put your jacket on and come out and be an adult.
Hey, Jim. So she fled from her car, left it right there. It's not really like we're trying to get her to come out. She comes outside. If she doesn't come out, then we aren't
going to
let her have you guys
take it. You give me a call.
Alright, sounds good, man.
You're the one making the choices. Put your jacket on, come out, and call your dad.
Would you mind maybe just staying here for now? I appreciate it. I know you got stuff to do, but we're giving her, like, a minute.
Come out. You can talk to your dad right here.
Can we hook it up?
Call your dad outside. Call your dad outside, and we will let him go. As soon as he hooks up, it's hooked up, so you... You need to hurry, because it's getting hooked up right now.
She don't need to go in cuffs right away, as long as she comes out.
Yeah.
No problem working with people if they come out and deal with it. I mean, yeah, we don't want to screw up her life anymore, but she's making bad choices right now. Yeah, we don't have to immediately put her in cuffs. You just, as long as she's out, you have control over her, let her call people, because that's going to go a lot smoother.
You can kind of, like, if you sit
finally decided to exit the house.
I'm not gonna call him. $250.
Alright. Do you need to call anyone else?
I need to call my dad. The VP is coming.
We're not gonna call your landlord. You're being decent.
This is
terrible.
Take a breath.
Because
I probably would have gotten pulled over. I
might
have to go to fucking jail. That's fucked up.
You'll get a signature bond for OER. On the street. That's why we cooperate. That's why you need
for
to
what?
Stop.
I will get a signature bond for what?
You would have been OER.
No, I'm not gonna get a signature bond.
Oh, no,
I don't know what that means.
If you would have originally stopped for him as soon as he turned on his lights, it would have been a signature bond and you would have went home.
Great. I would love hearing that. Great.
You gotta make good choices. That ain't a...
I'm fucking scared. I'm terrified. I've been to jail like 30 times. I'm fucking scared. I'm on probation.
You wanna call
I'm on a bond. I'm fucking terrified.
You wanna call your dad again?
Of course, he's supposed to be coming. He's not fucking answering the phone because I'm an idiot.
Would you give us permission to move it for you and just park it?
I'd rather just want my dad to come here. I want to see my dad at least.
Where would he be coming from? Because, I mean, obviously we can't sit here for an hour either.
I'm fucking almost here. Oh my god.
I'm recording. One second, guys. I'll be right back. All right, and my apologies. So let's pick up the rest of this case. Those are all valid charges here.
They read it, and then they determine if she needs to sit or not. Then it'll be all dependent if probation puts a hold on it. So.
I feel like you're bullshit. If I would've stopped, I wouldn't have went to jail.
I wouldn't have called probation.
If you knew that, I would've stopped.
I wouldn't have called probation.
Don't you think if I knew that, I would've stopped?
It always works a lot better when you're cooperative, though.
I have absolutely never had that experience in my life. By the way, their card was not in my house. It was in a bus, a door. I think you have a power trip, and I think that's the only way a cop can be out to like that. By the way, because I know you, and I know your sister, and you're way too young to be walking around like that, and you are one of the most arrogant cops in Cross I've ever met in my life.
Okay.
And that means a lot. No, it's true. That actually says a lot.
Well,
maybe don't go around smirking at people's windows, telling them you're in a bus to the door, because they're scared. That's not really you're protecting your...
You pose a lot of risk. I'll be arrogant. You were running through the line. Wrongfully so.
I never saw it.
I'm not fucking kidding you.
Am I going to get a signature bond or am I going to have a cash bond?
It'll be cash initially. And the judge has to review it within 48 hours.
It'll be cash right now?
Correct.
Okay, I'm talking about like Monday because I can't pay $4,000.
So the judge will look at it probably Sunday morning and then they'll decide if they're going to give you a signature on Sunday or if they want to hold you and talk to you at court. Depends on your charges for traffic. Normally they'll just do I don't know what they're gonna do, but normally they do a signature for misdemeanors and traffic, and then they'll hold felonies over for court.
Am I getting a charge for running?
Yeah.
Am I? Isn't that a felony?
I'm gonna watch my video and see it.
I literally ran because I'm fucking scared. By the way, not that I'm trying to fucking resist you, I fully came out. I just literally scared as fuck. And now I have no fucking choice. Hello. None. Zero. I'm not gonna make my dad pay. $300 for a stupid ass toe, and I'm not gonna get my door kicked in. So thank you for that. Sounds like I'm making a fucking felony for fleeing and eluding again.
You almost got sideswiped on three corners, girl.
Sounds like I have fucked, right? Thank God. Sorry, I thought I was getting arrested either way. And I came out of the fucking house. There's no way I was coming out of the house. You're welcome. I was not going to go inside. I would ask if you don't give me a felony because I'm trying to.
Give her a felony. Why, we don't think you're drunk, dear. You just think you're an idiot. Give us the charges. All right. Thank you, boys. We definitely appreciate you. And with that, that'll bring us to the end of the day here on From Day One. As always, please make sure you do like, share, and subscribe. Help us be with us to get to the 50,000 views, 1,000 subscribers. So Boxy and all of them can have that taken care of. Until then, have a great night, and thank you for watching From Day One. We'll see you tomorrow.